हॅलो एव्हरीवन, आय एम अरुणा राहुल नजरे फ्रॉम मराठवाडा मित्रमंडळ कॉलेज ऑफ फार्मसी पुणे. टुडे आय एम गोइंग टू प्रेझेंट कार्बन फुटप्रिंट ऑफ सस्टेनेबिलिटी फॉर द फार्मास्युटिकल फील्ड ऑन द बिहाफ ऑफ इंटरनॅशनल एफडीपी ऑन एन्व्हायरमेंटल अँड सस्टेनेबिलिटी कोर्स. नाव कमिंग टू दिस इज माय व्हिडिओ, वीक वन व्हिडिओ अँड वीक टू व्हिडिओ. Now coming to the video outcomes, after learning through the video, student will be able to know effect of pharmaceutical pollution on human environment, various standards for pharmaceutical waste management, carbon footprint and sustainability of the pharmacy or drugstore. Now these are the various ISO, IEE and industry standard norms. So first one is the ISO 14025. For the environmental product declaration has basis for the developing life cycle based carbon footprint for the pharmaceutical product. ISO 14025 is based on the standard for the life cycle assessment, that is LCA, for the described in the ISO 14040 or 44. ISO 14064 describes in the organizational reporting, and ISO 14067 which describes the product reporting. Now coming to the biomedical waste rule 1998, handling and disposal of the biomedical waste. Drug and Cosmetic Act regulates the manufacturing practices of the pharmaceutical, and part 1.4 is the disposal of pharmaceutical waste. Now coming to the WHO guideline 1999, which is for the safe disposal of unusable pharmaceutical in the emergencies. Now what are the carbon footprint? For footprint calculation or computation for the pharmaceutical waste and pharmacy, more than 200 companies present the globally pharmaceutical market. It only the 25 consistently report their direct or indirect greenhouse gas emission. The total global emission of the pharma sector amount to about 52 megatons in CO2 emission in 2015. By the 2025, overall pharma sector will need to the reduce its emission intensity by about 95% from the 2015 level. Healthcare climate footprint is a 4.4% of global emission. Now this is a process of manufacturing of the pharmaceuticals. So first manufacturing, then retail sale, consumer use, product disposal, waste disposal treatment, and last one is a post disposal treatment. So these are the various factors which are contributing into the carbon emission. This includes transportation, electricity, packaging material, waste material, water, employee, then disposal techniques. Also it includes the various manufacturing processes and products, solvents, ingredients, machineries. These all are contributing into the CO2 emission. These are the various formula which are useful for the calculation of carbon emission or carbon footprint. So total sum of the all these factor, it is known as a total carbon footprint by the pharmacy drugstore or the pharmaceutical manufacturing. As we know that in the pharmacy there is various manufacturing and compounding processes. In that processes these are various factors which contribute to CO2 emissions or which increases the level of carbon emission. So now coming to the sustainability, various solvent which are used into the pharmaceutical industry that are useful for the disposal of the various waste. Solvent disposal by the conversion to the energy can be more cost effective than the process of purification and reuse. It also reduces the fossil fuel consumption and carbon footprint. Use of the single use of the component or the system to the replace stainless steel equipment can eliminate the huge quantities of the water, possibly by the 80%, and the cleaning material from their production processes. With the single use of the component, they can also reinvest the plastic waste into their energy cycle for the overall carbon footprint reduction of the 55% in some cases. So these are the various approaches for the reduction of the carbon emission or which is useful into the environment and sustainability. So first one is a research question. State of the art in the sustainability assessment. Check priority to check to be tackled and how to tackle. So for that, various methodologies are applicable. First one is literature review, stakeholder survey, expert interview, and round table discussion. And outcomes, challenges and priority, action points, identification, reporting and dissemination of the best practices and the recommendations, LSE database, evaluation of the common harmonized framework. So this is a reverse flow of the pharma product return. So which are the product which are unused or expiry date, we can again withdrawal from the market or resend to the manufacturer for the disposal. So this is a reverse approach. By this reverse, first pharmaceutical manufacturing which sell drug to the state level agent sell the drug to the wholesaler, and finally the international buyer, retailer and end consumer. Again we reverse this process by the reverse flow of the product return, and by this method we can reduce the carbon emission or waste disposal of the product. Thank you.